You're right. I'm not sure what's up. You're feeling a playful mood? Okay. Don't jump over me. You know better. Good girl. Good girl. Good girl. Oh, you want a rub, belly rub too? Okay, there you go. Right, off you go.
Hey, g'day guys. It's Calvin and Poppy from the Cartoon Company. Chase is away today. He's doing other things. He has done an absolutely beautiful, beautiful job of prepping this vehicle and getting the oil leak sorted, checking it over and getting everything just right. So he's made it much easier for me to come in and wire up the ECU. This one, we have chosen a Haltech 2500 because we're going to run the engine and we're going to run the transmission. As per normal, we are starting on old Yeller, doing a bit of a check over, laying out the loom, getting it ready, and doing some testing. This is pretty much complete as far as I can go until I get relays and fuses all happening inside the cabin. This is going to sit like this, facing outwards. The ECU's plugs are going to pop in over the top, over the top like that. I've got to work out where I'm running the power supply out of the relays and fuses, whether I go straight through the back, whether I go around the end. So I'm actually going to lift this loom off and do a test fit. Just a little mental note, this is the wiring that came out of the Zephyr. Oh, it's a bit wrapped up here. So there's the factory crown plugs, so none of that was removed. There's this, which I sat down and I went to start deciphering this stuff. I did that one, that was the water temp. And that one is the oil pressure. So I got those. And I got into this bit and I went, oh, I'm not really quite sure what to do with that. And instead, I just went over to the car. Had a bit of a look under the car to work that out. I knew this was the engine check light. Basically on this one, I went, what in the car is working? And we did that right back at the beginning. We had an oil light. The temp gauge on the dash actually worked. It's got the Toyota sensor in it, so it must be kind of close enough to the old Ford Zephyr one. Don't know, but it kind of worked. But it had an aftermarket one, which suggests that maybe the one on the dash isn't as accurate as we might like. Then I looked at reverse lights and all those other bits and pieces, and none of that was working. Well, there was a check engine light, which I found. There was basically a big bunch of cabling going across the vehicle, which I haven't got here. There was a big, like a main battery cable, and then it branched out to a whole lot of connections. And then there was the temperature gauge, the oil pressure light, a start trigger, and an ignition. So I just tested them in the vehicle. And then the check light was on its own lead with its own power supply. So that was pretty simple. So I just basically, instead of trying to decipher all the wiring loom and what was going on with that, I just deciphered the four connections in the car. I haven't touched them. I've just cut the four wires off, put a termination on it, put a plug on it, left them alone. I'm not going to touch that at this stage. And then I'm going to build a loom to go across to my relays and fuses. So I've got on the same plate where the factory ECU was and those other relays were mounted, we've remounted on our own relays, relay blocks, and a fuse box. And this has got everything in that we need. I'll have to do up these nuts nice and tight. We've mounted them on just little upstays, little insulators, just to keep it off the board for us so we can get the wires underneath. So my next step is to get in and actually test this and test that. To connect it into the vehicle, right when I was talking about plugs and connections, there it is. Is that one. So that 12 pin plug is going to be the dash plug. I happened to put a spare earth in, and that was number 13, that was unlucky, so it wouldn't fit in the plug. And that one is for the fuel pump relays, which are now in the boot. So instead of running power for the fuel pumps all the way through the vehicle, all the way forward and all the way back, we've mounted the pump relays out in the boot. So while you weren't here, I fitted the loom and put the smaller injectors in.
Well done.
And you get to work and you didn't even notice I'd done it.
I didn't look at the car. Quite hard to notice something when you don't look at it.
I put an extra earth strap too. So I put a big extra main cable below the alternator there, into the factory spot.
Did you do the earth on the...
Yeah, what I did is I jotted the earth from the fan across to the bottom of the engine. And I thought that would be a good way to do it. In the cabin, I actually found some nasties in that loom, eh?
What's that?
The loom that came out of it.
Oh, it wouldn't surprise me.
You know that... The start inhibit, I couldn't work out the start inhibit switch. And it was actually wired. It was wired into the park. So I think it may have only started in park. I didn't go any further. I just went to the car. And there were four wires going from this side to the other side. Oil light, water temp, start, and the ignition switch. And the ignition switch is actually, if you go too far in start, it actually switches off. But I hope it's not a problem in service. But so I found those four wires, put a plug on it, call it good, and start everything over there is going to be new. So I've got to do inside the cabin. I'll put a bit of heat sheet sleeving down the fuel line, and my gearbox stuff all fits like it should. It was really hard doing that with the headlight on, and it's like, couldn't see it because there's the exhaust in the way. And have you noticed the back brakes are a bit sticky?
No, just so haven't.
Yeah, I like to move it, it's a little sticky, so I hope that comes right because that will affect performance. Those Falcon calipers seize up. Righto. I'm going to get inside the cabin and fit the relays and fuses. I went with the two wire stepper. Probably because I was out of outputs.
I didn't look at the throttle body too.
Oh yeah, I did the throttle body last night. I got covered in aluminium as I went home so I could get all the aluminium off me at home. We need to build a little bracket here too. Bolts on those and then just a little steel bracket of some sort.
What are you doing?
The main power cables go up behind the dash and they're sharp stuff.
Oh.
So I'm putting split sleeve over it as a temporary or a fix. It might be a permanent fix. And I put a little bit where it goes through the floor. There's not a proper grommet. So we'll talk to the owner about that too.
No.
About doing something more permanent where it goes through the floor.
I did make a bit of rubber that sits over it.
Yeah.
Just to sort of, I don't know. It worked out to attach it yet. I'm fun.
I'm probably perfectly sized for this job, actually.
Yeah.
If I can find my scissors. So a bit of dash loom to go. Running from this side to the other side. Have I got that twiddly knob here?
Twiddly knob.
This one.
Yeah.
I got the twiddly knob to go fitted. Woohoo!
What's the switch for?
That's overdrive, on off.
Oh.
But I can't make the light go because it's a negative switch.
Oh. And well, that's not a very, you need a positive switch then.
Yeah, so the light won't come on, but at least doing this, like, I haven't affected the rest of the vehicle.
No.
The rest of the vehicle is still...
Zephyr.
It's still very much Zephyr, isn't it?
Hmm.
I've got my little glow worm. Right, let me get back to work.
Oh, good fun.
Yep, go!
Thank you.
That worked. I can actually see it now. Go 100. So we're checking the base timing. One of the first things to do. Yep, go. So our timing is getting close. Foot to the floor for me. I'm just going to give it a bit of go juice and see if it makes some noise. Close up. Go juice. Go, go. She definitely wants to go. Let's turn the injectors on, eh? So we have cranked up oil pressure. Brum, brum. We have got the big squirters in it. We've got 360s. I'm good to go anytime.
That's my sucky.
It almost sounds good.
I wish we got to drive it before.
Same. I really wish we'd got to drive it before. Sounds better, eh? Sounds a bit more nasty. I think with the intake on, hopefully that'll quieten that stepper down. Bang on 15 degrees. And it's generating 15 degrees on the ECU, so that's...
Just 1, 2, 100.
What's that front one?
Oh,
you see, it's good. 200 and something, yep, we're good.
There we go.
I'm gonna get a wide band going. We'll measure the mixtures. We can actually start doing some tuning. Woo-woo-woo! Do we have a fan going? We've got a fan going.
A fan, yeah. Thermostat's open.
Good. It's got a good oil pressure. Oil pressure's beautiful. Fuel pressure's keeping up.
Good.
I'm super happy with the result today. I can turn the key, it starts, and it runs. I've sorted the wideband. And I just worked my way through each little issue as they came up. One wire at a time, and you get to the end. Tomorrow, we've got some transmission setup to do. I'm gonna go home and do a little bit more reading, just so I've got everything through my head. There's a lot been going on. And it doesn't hurt to do a bit of revision. But everything's pretty much doing as it should, when it should. Idle's good. I'll do some cold start in the morning. It'll give me the opportunity to do that. And I've gone ahead and booked the dyno pretty soon too. So we really start to get under the pump, trying to get it ready for that dyno, because I don't want to muck around. I want to have it driving pretty well as it should, as a normal road car, for when it goes to the dyno. You can see in here, this is our overdrive on off switch. So I've got to set that up, and our rotary dial, which allows us, when I go home, I'll set up some different gear shifts with the rotary dial.